Chapter 147 of Jujutsu Kaisen reveals a heartbreaking death, setting an even darker tone for the upcoming arc of the series. Warning, the following video contains spoilers from Jujutsu Kaisen Chapter 147 by Gege Akutami. So without any further ado, let's start reviewing this chapter. Jujutsu Kaisen Shibuya incident arc dominated much of the series' recent chapters, and its aftermath has left the world in much darker place. Unfortunately for Yuji Itadori, Megumi Fushiguro, and Yuta Okotsu, and many other people who are loyal to the Satoru Gojo, the situation hasn't got any easier with the start of Omnia's Kyuling game. Now in chapter 147, the event has sadly taken its first victim, and it's one from the Jujutsu Tech family. Clear lines have been drawn in Jujutsu society now that Satoru Gojo has been sealed with the prison realm by Geto and branded a traitor by the Jujutsu elders. Those who have been attributed with helping Gojo, like Principal Masamichi Yaga, have executions order on their lives. Due to those orders and perhaps a different ideology, Yaga comes face to face with Jujutsu Tech Kyoto's principal Gakuganji, who has come to fulfill the elders' commands. The battle itself is unseen, but the impact of death of Yaga is felt immediately. With Gojo being such a powerful presence, he is only a fix for all of this situation. So his current removal from the story means he can no longer be a safety net for Yuji and others. The powers that the one that opposed the positive changes Gojo was championing for the Jujutsu world immediately took full advantage of Gojo's removal to set an even darker tone for the Kyuling game arc. As things gear up for the twisted competition, Yuji, Yuta, Fushiguro, Choso, and Yuki meet the enigmatic and immortal Master Tengen to learn more about Kenjaku's plan. However, elsewhere, we catch up with the Yaga. Chapter 147 opens with a conversation between Yaga and Gakuganji, the two principals of Jujutsu Tech Tokyo and Kyoto, respectively. As Yaga sat imprisoned in a jail cell, Gakuganji inquired about how he created Independent Curse Corps Panda. Gakuganji explains that the higher-ups fears that Yaga can make an army if he know how to create more cursed corpses like Panda. Yaga replied that he is not sure how exactly Panda was created, or at least had no intention of revealing that information to Gakuganji yet. However, the story shifts to another flashback where Yaga is with another independent curse corps named Takeru and several others. Takeru is then revealed to be the replicated soul of the woman's dead son, crafted into the cursed corps core. Though the clash between principals isn't shown, the grave injuries that Yaga suffers are. However, before he succumbs to his injuries, Yaga explains to Gakuganji the secret behind creating independent curse corpses. Essentially, three highly compatible souls must be inputted into the cores, and they will constantly observe one another. Eventually, once they stabilize, the cursed corpse will become self-aware and, after 3 months, will achieve self-sustaining cursed energy. Yaga's final words reveals that his revelation of this Gakuganji is a curse from me to you. After it's too late, Panda arrives on the scene, brushing past the shocked Gakuganji, who asked the cursed cop why he didn't immediately attack him. Panda heartbreakingly responded that he is not like humans and understands that Gakuganji was only acting on orders. However, the chapter closes on his words. But remember one thing, even the Panda cries as he weeps from his fallen father. Gege Akutami's focus on the division and corruption within the Jujutsu world will undoubtedly be an integral element of the current arc. And Yaga's death means that the battle lines have never been more evident. With Gojo and Yaga now out of the picture, hardly anyone could keep the higher-ups in check. Beyond that, the Kyuling game, which was started by the head of the Kamo clan, one of the three major Jujutsu clans, appears to be the power play by the clan to wrestle power back from Gojo clan. Kenjaku, who at one point masqueraded as Noritoshi Kamo, the evilest sorceress that has ever lived, it implies to have manipulated these events per his plan to revive the golden age of Jujutsu. With broken hearts and world of disarray, Yuji, Fushiguro, Panda and others on their team have a daunting task: defeating Kenjaku, stopping his Kyuling game with minimal casualties, and stopping both of the cursed spirits and Jujutsu higher-ups from taking over Japan. What are your thoughts about the recent chapter of Jujutsu Kaisen? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel because I post daily anime content about top 10 top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sort of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and that was it. And I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.